reason was actually they were trying to create products, but all products failed. Because the reason is they were not talking, thinking about only one person. Who is that person? Who is that person? They were not thinking about that one person. They were actually trying to do all these product development and all the things. They were not thinking about one. What is that? Yeah, they were not thinking about the customer. They were not thinking about what these guys are doing. Online, and online users, what online users are doing. They don't have an idea. They're creating products. They are called themselves Silicon Valley startups. They're talking all kinds of jargons. Right? We were all following. To be frank, we were fresh out of college, what we are doing. We were actually, you know, we were trying, we were thinking that something, a really big thing is going to happen, but never happened. And then there were few companies which actually become successful. Why? Very few companies become successful. Why?
They focus only to the customer.
Because they exactly know what exactly people want. They are able to identify. So now, in digital marketing, what we all talk about is we actually look at this one. This is like the online behavior of a user. What does a user do? So you have to literally look at what is a user can do. User actually normally does certain things. Now today if you go and ask anybody, at least the guys who are using most of the online stuff, go and ask, these guys will say, first thing I do, I go to Google and then do search. Now if Google says something, it is 100% validated. Am I right? Am I right? Hope? True or true?
Yes.
Exactly, yeah.
Yes.
So if Google says something, exactly it is true. So I have, in my digital marketing, I have something called social media optimization. If I am able to do it right, my business will be able to, you know, get that thing, you know, on the search. So if I am on the search, then people will gonna really look at me as somebody who is an authentic person. Right? So that can be done using your web. So that is one of the things. So what we do for that is we actually look at the online user behavior. One is search. They do go to search. Now today, if you really look at what is the search which is there, whether it is going to be Yahoo or MSN or what?
Bing.
Today, Bing. Which is the search where people are using? Only one. That is only one 800-pound gorilla. Nobody else can there be there. So he is the only guy who is going to dominate forever. And another thing I'll tell you, the entire world, what it is, what these guys are searching is there, the data is there with only one company, which is Google.
But China is Google's
bank. Maybe. Only China. There is only one guy, maybe North, China and North Korea. These are excluded out of map.
They're part of Mars. They're part of Mars.
So that's the thing, you know. So one is this Google. So with Google is going to be the one who's going to control the entire online space. And already they're making, you know, I think you used to say the world stat is $90 billion. I don't know how much billion now. But anyway, so Google is going to be the company, of course, for at least for a few years to dominate this space. Maybe if Apple and Microsoft and others are able to probably come out with new things, maybe artificial intelligence, and there is going to be more disruption happening. We don't know what is going to happen for the next 10 years. We all hope and pray that all of us will be safe. Okay. Fine. So the next thing is social. So what exactly happened after Sir said it was Orkut? There was a time where Orkut was famous and all of them were very happy to suddenly found a way to find all their old classmates who all studied in schools, colleges and all those things. They found them through Orkut, and suddenly what happened? Something else happened. The new thing came, something called Facebook, and totally changed the entire scenario. So you have Facebook, you have Twitter, you have LinkedIn, so many social media channels you have. So social media is the next where people actually go. Today, everybody is into social media. I'm very sure about it, and of course we see every day. And some of them, you know, particularly the women, to be frank. So that too, this generation I'm talking about. Okay, when they wake up early morning, first thing what exactly she does is not even looking at her husband's face or the, you know, child's face. First thing she takes is the Facebook, and then she says the status. Right? So I'm telling you the fact. So that's what has happened. At least WhatsApp. And another thing now it is taken away most of people's times is WhatsApp, of course. So these things, tools, have actually people are predominantly using throughout the world. So, as a digital marketer, we look at that. One. Okay. Two. Yeah. Three is, of course, email is not dead. Email is a very successful tool. Still people actually go and And most of the B2B businesses, email is the one. Yeah, next. So these are the things which we actually we focus on. Now, so these are the channels, actually, channels of marketing, if you really look at it. Hope you know marketing, if you really have studied somebody in MBA or somebody who have been a marketing manager, they all talk about something called channels of marketing. In என்னோட செய்தி எப்படி எடுத்துன்னு போய் அங்கே கேட்குறது. I have to take my message and reach it to my target audience. And I have to do it through these channels. One is your Google, another is your Facebook, or LinkedIn, or Twitter, or whatever, so social media. Next is through email. So these are the channels of marketing which we use as digital marketers. Next thing what we do is, of course, I want to get into this using digital marketing we are able to get the traffic to our website. If you really look at this traffic, there are two kinds of traffic you can classify. One is called the organic traffic, which happens on its own, which is like, you know, let's say a search center, like, you know, he said almost free. So almost free, let's say, but not really free. Yeah. But anyway, it is almost free. That is organic traffic. That's called free traffic. Another thing is called paid traffic. So you have to spend money in order to get your, response, whatever. So these two things are there. Now, if you really see, look at the organic traffic or the free traffic, I say mostly optimization. Mostly optimization. Either it is going to be search engine optimization or whether it is going to be social media optimization. These two things happen. And if an email, of course, is also one of the way to get the free traffic. And the paid traffic is more advertisements. So advertisements on the Google, advertisements on the Facebook, advertisement on the Twitter, advertisement on the Instagram, advertisement on the LinkedIn, advertisement on the YouTube. YouTube is also part of Google. The Google has bought, so you use only Google's AdWord platform to advertise. So there is something called AdWords. Google created one of the biggest platform today online is none other than owned by Google. It's called AdWords. AdWords alone makes more than $70 billion in in revenue. Now this platform, now to yesteryear, I think it was advertisement was totally different. It was like what a newspaper or a publishing house says what the price is, that's the price I can actually go for today. I mean, long back. Right? So what I have to do is, suppose they say this one is actually 15,000 rupees, then I have to go for that. Otherwise, I can't put an ad. Now today it is not so. Even if you have 300 rupees, you can put an ad. Depending upon your budget, depending upon your target group, you can do that. So that kind of platform which is created by your Google, AdWords. Sir, any questions? Yes, sir. Sir, please.
You see.
No. I would like to. You are about to ask me, please. No, I should not go like a bullet train. I should stop sometime. Yeah.
Because we are experiencing AdWords and we also have AdSense.
Mm. Oh, good.
Okay.
So, any questions? Anybody? So far, so good.
It's going wonderfully. We will ask questions at the end.
Okay. Great, sir. Okay. So, AdWords is a platform where you can actually, put advertisement on the Google. All right. So, what kind of ads I can put? There are a lot of ads I can put. I can put search ads. I can put display ads. I can put video ads. So much of things are there. The platform, on the platform, if I can actually put these ads, where does it come? It actually comes on your search pages. Most of you, probably the elder generation, doesn't know the difference between the ad and the organic search. Probably they may click on it and then they will land on it. Even all those people, everybody, right? So they will buy products or they will click and things like that. So that is one thing which you do. And it is based on keywords. As I told you, what all the things people search, all these kind of search is actually tracked by one company, of course, Google. So using this particular marketing, you will be able to get the right kind of response. So this is one marketing. Okay, next. Now, as I told you, I can use any tool in order to facilitate my digital marketing. Right. Now here an example I have given. Okay. In this example, what I have given is like there is an advertisement. It can be any ad. It can be a Google ad or a Facebook ad. Now people actually click on the ad, and then they land on the landing page. Landing page is nothing but a website. And on the website, I capture the data. What data am I capturing? Is their phone number, email ID, or whatever, a name, phone number, email ID. And that I use it for email marketing. So this is something, a kind of a funnel, which is used by, predominantly used by digital marketers. Today, if you go to any some of the websites, you will be able to see this kind of same kind of thing. Like, you know, on the Facebook, you might have an ad, you click on the ad, it actually goes and gives you, asks you to give your phone number, email ID and all things. They capture it, and after you capture it, then you actually give them emails, and probably you might do more of content-based marketing. So the content-based marketing today has taken up very much. Because the reason is, as I told you, the SEO, go to the next slide, sir. So, as I told you, it's not about digital, it's also traditional marketing. So, next. So, coupled with that, next. So, Google has done a lot of updates on their algorithm, banning sites which are not as per their norms and things like that, people who cheat Google and all those things.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Slides are accessible.
Yeah. Yeah. Able to see? You're able to see?
Yes,
yeah. Right. So, there are a lot of algorithms which have been created by Google. Now, called Penguin algorithm, Panda algorithm, Hummingbird algorithm, so many algorithms. All these algorithms, the main focus was to make sure that people who cheat Google, and those people have to be penalized. So they did penalize. Now, because of those process, what has actually happened is content has become the king. Content has become the king. So without content, your entire digital marketing cannot survive, sustain. Now, any digital marketing today, any digital marketing agency, the major departments would be two things. One is the design, number two is the content. So today we need a lot of content writers. In the sense, content writers when it comes to creating marketing content, as well as people who create the back-end content. Both these content, you know, you need to have. Otherwise, digital marketing cannot survive. Right. So that's why in America, for example, the old content writers who were very successful, like example, I give you one guy called Bob Lai. Bob Lai is a very famous copywriter, digital, direct marketing guy. A direct marketing guy, now today, he is the one who consults for most of the digital marketing, you know, companies, where he is able to really create wonderful content, which, you can actually optimize on.
$200 per hour.
No? Right?
We charge $200.
Okay, great. Thanks for the information, sir. Okay. So, you have so many things happening because of this. Okay, next. Okay, so social, if you really look at social also as a page, so you have to create relevant content to attract the relevant audience, as I told you. So, I think marketing, if you really want to understand one thing, Seth Godin, somebody called Seth Godin has released a new book. I would always ask everybody to please you go and grab it and read it. It's called This is Marketing by Seth Godin. I've not completed it, I've just began it. I think I would have completed just 10% of the book. But then I would like to tell you the most important thing in that book is that what he suggests is marketing means it's not marketing to everybody. If you really look at, is somebody, I've seen so many people want to start a business, they will come and ask you, who is your customer? He will say, everybody is your customer. It means that you don't have a business. If you have to market, you have to have very specific set of target group customers. So that is a key essential message from that book. I would say marketing is about targeting. So you go to any marketer, you always talk about target group. Now in social media, what you have is they have created a wonderful, given you tools to create funnels.